Good evening. I've been watching you like all season. Heart in an open cell. Ayo. What is going on, guys? Pierce back here again today, and today what I have for you guys is an MOG class setup video. I'm going to be showing you guys the classes that I use when I am playing competitive scrims, GBs, tournaments, whatever it may be. I'm going to be showing you guys the classes that I use to try and give you the best advantage and hopefully help out your classes. As you guys saw in my last video, this video actually got taken down. I mentioned in my last video that some of the videos on my channel got taken down due to the fact that I put tags in my description. No longer going to be doing that, but I'm going to be trying to re-upload some of the videos that are made. Some of the videos that I actually had were some of my most popular videos that you guys heard in the last video. I'm not going to ramble on about that. Let's get right into classes. So to start off here, I have my regular Slayer class. This is the class that I use if I am... assigned a Slayer position, whether I'm going to be pushing out of the hill to get kills, stuff like that. I use nades instead of stuns. It's just a preference. You can use nades or stuns, even EMPs. Any of those really work. That's just my regular subclass. This is the class that I'll use if I'm designed to play the hill. So I run an overkill TAC-19 with advanced rifling. I know overkill may get banned soon, so I'm going to have to switch this class up and maybe just run a TAC-19 with a trophy, maybe two stuns instead of one, and then I might be able to equip like a flag jacket or something like that. But for now, before overkill gets banned, this is the class that adds a really, really good touch to it with close quarters and being able to stay alive in the hill. This next class is the class that I use most of the time for uplink. Instead of blast suppressor, I'm going to run hardwire. So what hardwire does, immune to system mag, EMP, really all the only reason I use it, so it's immune to EMP and stun grenades. When you're carrying the ball in uplink, you want to make sure that you're immune to all stun grenades, EMPs, so you can make sure that you're not obviously stunned and you don't get EMP'd, so you can't jump in and get the 2-point play. If you're looking for a good class to use for uplink, I recommend this one. I recommend also being able to go back and forth with this one, just because not having blast suppressor in advanced warfare is obviously really, really hard to do with the way the map movement is, and just trying to stay alive. Next class that, that you see on your screen is my capture the flag subclass. So what I use this class for is I don't run any exo launchers, and I run overcharged as another perk one, and I use it for overclock. So what overcharge does is it makes your exo ability last a lot longer than it normally would, and I just use it to get across the map. If I do pull a flag, I can have overclock a lot longer than I normally would, and so it's just helpful to run flags back and forth and as well as get across the map pretty fast. Last class that I have for my respawn classes is my bow. This is really only for CTF. If my team needs me to run, if the team needs an extra AR and someone else is already running a sub, I am the main sub for my team. I usually don't switch out and run a bow, but just in case they want me to run one on CTF, I do have this class. I usually run frags just so I can nade over off the break, and then it's just basic stuff after that. So moving on over into the S&D classes, the first class that you're going to see on your screen is an IMR overkill with the shotgun. This is a really, really good class. A lot of people call it a scumbag class, but I'm not going to lie, I like this class a lot. Like I said before, overkill might get banned, so I may have to switch it up and just keep an IMR on. May have to take the TAC-19 out completely. I can run an extra stun and maybe another perk, but yeah, this is a really good class. For it's the IMR melts online, especially if you have a good connection to the host. Next class is just a basic bow class. You have mute. It's basically the same thing as my one from the respawn, just I have mute instead of overclock, and I run stuns instead of frags. This is just really a basic class for when you're playing straight up at a bomb site or straight up defending a site or something like that. This class is my overkill LMG subclass. This class is really useful, especially on biolab, if you're going to sit kind of in the pit where you spawn on the sentinel side, or on the atlas side, I apologize, and you can just kind of sit back and watch the bomb site in purple. You can watch back purple, you can watch kind of the cross into purple, and after round 5, when the yellow building drops in the back snow towards the other spawn, it's really easy to watch it with an ameli, especially with the thermal sight. I recommend using all three of these attachments for it. I don't run a perk 2 just because I don't have enough class slots for it, and I'd rather run a... Actually, you know what? I'm going to take this off. I've been meaning to take this off. I want to run advanced rifling instead of the quick draw on my ASM1.
Fast hands, I just decided to take that off just because I don't really switch back. It's not really needed to switch back and forth too fast when you are running this gun. So yeah, that's really that. And then the extra ability is obviously mute for S&D. This class is the class that I use when I'm trying to get aggressive. So this class is really good for terrorists when you're rushing on the offensive side, when you can run through the wooden tunnel straight to their spawn. I like to run up the stairs and try and get in the enemy face and really try and get first blood, or maybe get my team in a position to trade where after they get the trade, they'll be in a better position to win the round. This class is just really an overall aggressive class. I just run Tactician and I run Overclock instead of running maybe, you know, frags or stuns or something like that. Alright guys, that is going to do it for my class setup video. I hope that you did enjoy. Like I said, since this video did get taken down, I wanted to re-upload just because I enjoy making these class setup videos. It helps you guys out and it also helps me out and realizing some mistakes that I did make in my classes. But nonetheless, hope you did enjoy the video. If you did, please make sure to leave a like. That helps me out a ton. If you haven't already subscribed to the channel, make sure you subscribe. That helps me out even more. Follow my Twitter and live streams, which will all be down in the description below. Thank you guys so much for watching once again. This has been Priyosk. I'll catch you guys later.